Hello there. Just wanted to try something out here. I haven't yet streamed with my new setup, so I thought just doing some casual flying today and see if there are any technical issues or if it just works with a old setup. Right. So first, let me do a little check if this is actually running here. Just one second. And okay. Yeah, at least something's happening here, which looks fine. So I'm going to take, which ship should I take? Probably the 600i, maybe. Have to see if that's available or I have to claim it, as I don't want to wait that long. Yeah, then we see from there if we are flying somewhere, if we're doing mission, but probably I'm more about exploration today. Bit tired. Yeah, I had too much pizza yesterday, I think, so that could be the reason. And yeah, I mean, this is still 312 here. I'm not playing on the PTU. So if you wonder, because every streamer currently is playing the new patch, at least that's how it feels like to me, but I don't have access to it and I'm not even sure if I would want to play that now. Ah, there's the train. Go, 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 go. Still not made my mind up what I think of the new update. Some stuff in this, it's kind of cool, but not really seeing myself doing much of it. I mean, gameplay-wise, it's mostly about the new caves and the new delivery missions. Caves are a bit problematic for me with motion sickness, and I didn't like the old caves at all. I didn't have fun exploring those. And I don't really see how that changes just because they get bigger. But we'll see. I'll definitely give it a try. And yeah, from what I've seen, it's also mostly the entrance that's bigger, but then you also get these claustrophobic tunnels. I'm not a big fan of. And I'm not very good with orientation, so I get lost in there pretty quickly. And yeah, then get motion sick, and then bah. Yeah, and the delivery missions, I mean, I kind of like doing delivery missions, but normally, it's just not worth it for the rewards. And I haven't heard very positive, surprising things about the new ones. So I don't know if they reward much more. But yeah, as well, I'm going to give it a try at someday when it's live. Or maybe when it's on OpenPTU. And we see. Yeah, I mean, the ship-to-ship docking, that's still reserved for the Constellation, and I don't have one. And yeah, and even that, I mean, it's cool, but you do that, I don't know, maybe two times. Okay, first let me claim this because this takes forever. Just for the future. You do this one or two times, and then, well, I guess you've seen the docking, right? It's not that interesting. It doesn't really open up all that new gameplay possibilities or anything. So, think ship to station docking is a bit more interesting, but still, I wouldn't expect much to happen there. So, yeah, it's a rather slow first patch of the year. I mean, it normally is. Hey, what's that? Come on, Kirsten. Give me my ship. Well, I'm afraid this just won't work, so probably take a small one then and going to claim it on a different location just so to repair this issue. I mean, I think I did leave it somewhere, nowhere around here, so I even wonder why I was able to retrieve it and didn't have to claim it. Okay, so yeah, I'm going to take the 100i because I've read that it's currently broken on the PTU. You can't roll, I think, or something. So maybe fly this ship as long as it still works. Okay, hangar 9. Yeah, and I want to get away from Lorbil as a spawning point as well, so that's also something to consider. I could have taken the Nomad to a little bounty, but yeah, then again, I think there's a reputation wipe, and I don't really need the currency right now. Nah, no combat today. Too exhausting. Okay, there she is. The little burp. Yeah, I really got used to fly this thing. It's so fast and it just feels great flying around with it. Even though at first I was a little hesitant because, yeah, I mean, I already have a couple of small ships and the Pishas is quite fast already. But with the AUEC I made from Xenothreat, yeah, I just spent it on this and I didn't regret it. Not at all. Hello? Ah, there it is. It's just fun. It's a fun ship. Though I'm still a bit disappointed by the interior. That's not the luxury standard I would want to see from an Origin ship. It's a bit too cool and steel, metal-y, and I want some wood grain in my ships. And I really hope that's not a trend for Origin, a new design style in general, because if there will be a 400i, I would be very interested in buying that, but not if the interior looks like the 100i's interior. Nice view we got here. Okay. So, straight up. I mean, that's such a difference. 2 days ago, I was flying with the 890 to take some shots for the video I posted about the luxury theme on my channel. And man, that takes a long time to get that thing out of atmosphere. And even when you did so, I tried to target the jump point, the quantum point. And it was so hard because the ship just didn't want to go any more up an angle. This was really pulling at full force. And now we are already out here. Man, that's so fast. So the 890 is definitely not a daily driver ship. It takes way too much time. Okay, first let me think. Where do I want to put my spawn point? At Everest, or are we going somewhere completely different today? I think I might want to check out some moons on Microtech. So yeah, let's get to Port Tressler, I think. That's definitely a better location. Ooh, didn't I set the course? Microtech, set route. No. Clear route, set route. There is no route. Okay. Then just over here, do a little in-between step over the array, and that should fix the star map not finding a route. Are so many workarounds for that star map. Once you figured everything out, you normally always find a way to get where you want to go, but there are so many occasions where you have to do weird stuff to actually use it. So now I would expect this to work. Yep. Yeah, well, too many in-between drums, and it was not able to calculate that road. Ah, and it was very close to the surface here, so maybe that was also an issue. But whatever, we are on our way. Ooh. Not sure if you're supposed to fly that low with the quantum, but all right. And yeah, I just registered that I still have the music turned on because yesterday a friend visited me, a friend of mine, and I wanted to show off the game. And he was confused that there was no music, so I turned it on. Normally I don't have it on, but here for streaming I think it's fine. Yeah, okay, now we're in quantum. What are we doing? There's not much to do on this ship. That's still something that I wonder how it's actually going to work. From my understanding, they plan to extend the quantum travel times a lot, so it takes way longer sometime in the future or when the game is released. And also other star systems, planets will be further apart. And I think it's fine if you have something to do during quantum travel, but if you're just sitting in your ship and that's it, that's kind of boring. I really like the spec here. Oh, I think I'm not wearing a helmet. Yep. So, better do this just in case. I always forget to put it on. Ha, there it is. The only item I actually spent money besides my two starting ships, that helmet. Really wanted to have that. I really dig the motorcycle helmet look. Still no light? The helmet. Doesn't it have light? Okay, I'm confused now. Well, whatever. Okay, and I'm getting a bit thirsty, so how about getting something to drink over at Potresla? That sounds like a good idea to me. Yeah, I really don't like this bed. I mean, who wants to sleep on something like that? That's luxury, that's origin, not in my book. Though just sitting around here is kind of cool. And I mean, for such a small ship, you don't get too claustrophobic in here. It's way better than the Aurora in that regard. It's all blurry. Had too much to drink. Yeah, it's not that I'm going to take any interesting shots in here, but just wasting my time. Who cares? Okay. So. No. Yeah. I mean, as I said, if you get a big ship with all the stuff that you can do in there, I think it's cool. And traveling takes longer. You can do some briefing. You can talk to your orc mates, to the whole crew, and prepare stuff and whatnot. But if you're sitting in something like this, or maybe even smaller, hey, that's going to be really boring. And some people I think consider that it's very suspenseful because there can be a mantis that pulls you out of quantum, and there can be a pirate attack at any point. So they say, oh, you shouldn't go AFK during your quantum jumps. That should be something that is punished. But really, sitting in front of your PC for 30 minutes doing nothing? I mean, okay, at least I've got a second screen here, so I could watch YouTube or whatever. I mean, I read from Lovecraft stories on stream during Quantum, during my other streams, just to kill the time. But yeah, I'm still not quite sure what to think of that, but I guess we'll see. Generally, there were many things I had concerns about, and normally they turn out quite okay, not as bad as I expect. So, for example, with the eating and drinking, I was very hesitant about that. I mean, many people still are, but I think it's totally fine. I think there's still some misconception that people see those mechanics as survival mechanics, because yes, there are survival games where you have to eat and drink, but in this game, it's not so much about getting survival mechanics in there, it's more about the immersion. I mean, you have to drink or eat so rarely, but you have these occasions from time to time that you have to do it and you have to take care of it, and it's just a tiny, tiny puzzle piece in your everyday routine. And I'm all for that, having more stuff to do to mix up whatever you're doing. So, for example, my Nomad during Quantum, I could cook. That would be cool. I mean, that's better than doing nothing, right? And I don't think that it's annoying or anything. No. I mean, I was afraid at first that you would need to do that all the time and it would really annoy you, but that's okay for me in my book. I mean, we still have to see if you're in systems where it's really hard to get somewhere, and if you really haven't planned ahead, I think it could be frustrating. You got all this great mission and you've been out there exploring for days, and then you just die of hunger or thirst. That could be rather stupid, but maybe there's some first aid, last resort pizza delivery service or something in case you really, really need something and you're willing to pay up a lot for it. I don't know. No idea how that would work, but all right, here we are, Port Tressler. Didn't I switch the comm over before? Or did it forget that? That's something. I'm never using any of my MFDs because I'm not really deep into combat or anything else. So I'm normally just using it for landing permission and communications. And there's so few ships that have that as their default setting, and it's still not saving which MFD menu you've selected. So that's kind of annoying. Okay, there we are. Flying in this thing just makes me want to go down there on Microtech and just do some speed flying until I crash. I think that might also be a nice idea. We could do that. Okay. Is it on the left side? Yes, all right. And exit on the right, yeah. Okay. Let me check. Still wearing my helmet, right? No. Yeah. Okay. And these stairs are really nice. That's so much better than a ladder. At first I thought, it doesn't make a big difference, but once you get used to those, you really start to hate ladders or elevators or anything like that. I mean, I do like the immersion that you have to get on your ship every time and get off and get that animation and stuff. I'm fine with that, but this plays into ships where you don't need to wait that long to get there. Are there any other chips that you can get in so quickly? I mean, chips with RAMs are also quite fine. But I think the 100i is probably the one where it's fastest to get on and off. Hot dogs. Yeah, they also sell drinks. Shoo. And I'm a bit hungry. I think I might want to eat something as well. So take off the helmet first. What do we want? What am I craving? I mean, I need to. This is pink, right? So I need to drink this. Okay, I think if you hold down the button. Yeah. Drink it all up. The finger, though. That's a cool detail. I never noticed that. And yeah, just throw it away, obviously. Oh, well. It did go somewhere. Okay, the way is I'm not showing up without the helmet, right? Classic dog. I think that's fine. There we go. Thank you, madam. She has not a lot of hair. Ah, there it is. Okay. Was a little worried about you. Wasn't there some armor or helmet I wanted to buy just for the video shoot? I think I was missing something. No, I don't remember. Okay. Put it back. Ah, there it is. Okay, everything on 100%. We're ready to go. Can just go back there, right? Pet one. Ah, I wanted to claim the 600i if possible. Forget that. Obviously, I forgot the number one. Yeah, that's hard to remember. Okay. Here we go. Okay. I would want to go to the obsidian fields, but I have no idea which location that is. I always stumble over this location by accident. Whenever I'm posting some images, everyone is asking, "Oh, where did you take that image? Where did you take that image?" And I'm always like, "I don't know, somewhere, Microtech. At least normally I know the planet or the moon, but that's about it." Where we left at? I think that the server actually did. Oh, and it's still open. Yeah. Whoops. Who cares? I think that the server is discriminating bigger ships. I think they despawn way faster. At least during my video shooting, at one point I stepped out of the 600i, and after a few minutes, it was just gone. Okay, let me see. Can we refuel now? We can repair, but not refuel. That's weird. I don't want to repair, but I think we still have enough fuel, right? Hydrogen zero? Really? That's bad. That's how. Okay, I guess we didn't start with a full tank, but I mean, I did turn the engines off. Not power. What does that mean? That's forbidden. That button is illegal. Okay. Ah, hydrogen 100. Okay, but quantum is now down. Yeah, whatever. Okay, no. Anything changed? Nope. Okay, if we hover a bit up. Yeah, that did it. I'm amazed that that workaround still exists. Fill me up. Thank you very much. No, not at 100 yet, but all right. Okay. Let's see. Where are we going to jump? We are jumping over there, wherever this is. Emergency shelter. No, I don't like it. Mining facility. I think that's better. I'm not seeing anything here. Okay. Where is the... Oh, there it is. Yeah, I sometimes have to disable reshade. It makes reading the UI a bit impossible at times. I mean, I got that standard settings that I'm flying around now, but yeah, you always have to adjust when you're going to brighter or darker places or whatever. I mean, think that. Wow, it's very foggy down here. Do we have bad weather? Or is it just the atmosphere? Well, let's get down there and see for ourselves. I like that light setting here. It's not quite sunset or dawn. It's a little later, and you're not seeing all the details, so it's not optimal for shots, but I don't know. It kind of makes me feel cozy or something. Ah, it's raining, yeah? We got some weather down there. Or up here already. Some trees. I mean, I'm not 100% sure if I want to do high-speed flying under harsh weather conditions, but yeah, I don't care. I'll crash the ship anyway, so who cares? And don't expect too much. I'm not in any kind regard pro flyer. I know that you can decouple engine stuff and do crazy stunts. I don't know how to do that, but I know that this kind of looks nice, and I like that. Okay. I just recognized with a new Twitch setup that my video is cut off. It's 60:9 instead 4:3. Okay, that's too beautiful. I have to take a little screenshot here. Okay. One for the Instagram. No. Wait. Okay, and this is nice. Should I land somewhere around here? Do you want to take a walk until the sun is down? I think that's a good idea, right? Just an nice evening stroll in the woods. The long shadows. Ah, that's so cool. Okay, I have to see. I have to take another image here, I think. I want to see the sun coming through the trees. Okay, this is probably... I think it's already too low to make this work, because you get these amazing god rays when the sun is just right. But still, it's a nice place. I stay there. It's fine. Okay. Having that shimmer on the top of the ship. I don't like the angle too much. Can we have something? Okay, this could work. Get any lower? Okay. I think that's some nice framing. Wow. Okay. Really do like the colors here. I mean, the problem is that you don't really see them like I do because I'm not streaming in HDR. That's, as far as I know, still not possible. And this looks even more amazing for me. Have to believe me. But I think you're good, right? Okay. Well, let's go on a little hike here. See where we end up. I would want to have a cyclone now. It's more fun to race around with that than walking, but I think it's too much of a hassle to get it here now. So we're just going to walk. Is there. No. Would be really cool if there was fog beneath those trees, but I think it's not. Yeah. As I said, I'm just stumbling over these places. I have no idea. I bet when I post these screenshots, someone is going to ask me, where did you take that? And again, yeah, I think it was some Shumbin mining facility, right? But I don't know which one and whatever. It's really cool with that armor set that I put together here for Pink, that she's able to run for quite a while. I mean, I could take off the armor completely. We don't need that here, right? Although, it's minus 10 degrees. I mean, it's a bit cold, but should be able to survive that, right? But okay. Let's put that on. Okay, it's not even loading. And those. And well, we're not running around in high heels around here. Okay. I mean, I think I can just take a shot here from first person. Ooh, the jacket is really. Oh, okay. That's actually a bit cold. I'm sorry. Sorry. Put a shirt on, for God's sake. poor pig. Something, anything. Well, maybe something. Yeah, that looks better. Bit warmer. Ah, now I know what I wanted to buy. I don't have any gloves. Okay, we could do this later maybe. Oh, look at that. The sun is going down. When I get a bit closer, maybe we can get the God rays to show through those trees. The grass is getting a bit greener here. It's also nice. But yeah, she's making cold noises. She's shivering. But that's how it is now. Okay. Oh man, these noises really get to me. Maybe I'm going to trade again. Okay. What? Why didn't you? Okay, that's not my problem. You should put that on. It's not loading. I'm not taking a screenshot like that. People are going to hate me. Okay, let me see. Can I get the sunlight? Yes. I want to have her Maybe you move over here a bit. No, I think that was just well, at least that's there. That's nice, right? Oh, I do like that as well, but yeah. Oh, okay, now all the grass disappeared. Think that has something to do with the video memory when I'm taking screenshots. Sometimes it disappears, then I have to take another shot. No, don't close your eyes, Pink. Ugh. Okay, that might be funny. She looked to the left. That's so unpredictable to get a good shot of the face. Having that wisp of smoke there is also nice. Okay, I'm just going to take a lot of screenshots here. I'll eventually get something that looks nice. No, don't close your eyes. But maybe it even looks good with closed eyes. Who knows? Okay, let's continue exploring. Well, now this looks more. Ah, it's back. Fine. Phew. Yeah, I think we might get the God Rays. I'm not quite sure what you need for that. Maybe more air in the air. More air in the air. Water. More humid. Yeah, old gamer, I mean, I'm almost 40 now. That depends how you define old. Not one of those Fortnite playing kids, at least. But yeah, I know in the Star Citizen community, I'm probably not one of the oldest. Okay, let me get a bit. No, that's too much. Bit depth of field here. Yep. No, don't close your eyes. Pink. Just stay. Okay, fine. Would want to have a bit. Ah, there's a bit more shadow, maybe. Ah, no, now the hair is glitching out. Go back. Okay. Not closed eyes. Okay. I think that's fine. Let's continue. Ooh, that's also. Wow. Okay, now. Yeah, I mean, people can play whatever they want. If it's Fortnite, they should play Fortnite. As long as I don't have to, but. But though, I guess I wouldn't have played Fortnite when I was younger either. It's just not my genre. Ooh. That's a nice cozy place here. Can I sit down, maybe? No, she's not having it. Let's try again here. Really wish those emotes would be more stable sometimes. I mean, I can kneel down, but I have no idea when the EU was formed. I think it started as an economy union or something first before it became actual political one. But I have no idea when it transitioned. Well, then you have a shortcut remembering when it happened. I wish I had woods that looked like this near my home here. I mean, I was walking earlier today, but yeah, not in such a beautiful nature. Ooh, that hill. Let me get over there. Yeah, that also happens sometimes. Short circuits, dangerous stuff. And I think I have to move my camera a bit. Not sure if that works, but seems like my face gets cut off sometimes. Okay, I want to try something here. Shoop. As far out as possible, not the other way around. Yeah. I think it's kind of interesting, the shot. Not great, but yes, there's one that's came with my graphics card that can actually replace the background with whatever. And then I think somewhere on Reddit I found this looping background of the Mercury Star Runner. And I thought that was cool. Also using this as a background for virtual meetings on work at work. But people there don't recognize the Star Runner, unfortunately. They have no idea. Okay. Feel like I'm kind of done exploring here, but I don't want to go back to the ship all the way. So I'll probably just commit suicide. Though I want to see what's back there. All the way. Are you running? Yes, you are running. Okay. Okay, I think those are too many too many buttons at once. I can't take screenshots while running. Too bad. Yeah, while walking works, but not while running. Though maybe. Oh. Okay, now I hit some window shortcut. Okay, I stopped doing stupid stuff here. Okay. It is a view. It's not the greatest. I really hope that maybe it would be on a bigger mountain or something, but let's see. Okay. Well, we have a cozy little valley down there. I wonder there are some other trees. I wonder maybe we can get some fruit there. Maybe something grows. Okay, I want to check out that, then I'm going to get back to ship or to the space station. Because those trees, I think, are rather rare. I haven't seen them very often. Still frozen. Nice. But I don't think they grow any fruits, but I want to get closer to that. Star Citizen. I mean, I think it's just a great experience. That's why I'm really into it, because it offers stuff that no other game offers. I mean, if you call it a game at all, there's not much to do. And if you ask me if this game is ever going to be finished, I mean, depends on your definition of finished, but I'm not sure about that. But I've paid, I think, 100 euros on the game in total. And I've got so many hours of fun out of it. But I just love doing photography. So that's probably not something for everyone. yeah, I mean, I think it's the most ambitious game that has ever been developed. And that's something. But ambitions can fail, can be misled, and only the future will tell. Ugh, okay, whoops. I want to get this really, really sharp. So, if somebody says Star Citizen is a scam, that's stupid because you know, you can have all the information about the game out there. You can do some research before you spend any money on it. And there's more than enough people that have fun playing what is currently playable. But I totally understand if people just get annoyed by the state of the game. So that's that. Okay. I mean, looking at the detail of tree barks in a game where there's a whole solar system simulator that tells you something about detail and my fascination with the game. Okay, I have to get to do this differently. Nope. Okay. Please, camera, don't screw me up. Yes, this is cool. Ooh. Okay, do I want to zoom out a bit? That's nice. Thanks for the follow. Oop. If you're interested, you can also check out my YouTube channel. I'm more of a YouTuber, I would say, than a Twitch streamer. It's actually been a while since I streamed the last time. I think it's linked somewhere on my Twitch page, I hope at least. But you can also just search for Good Punk on YouTube. You'll probably find the channel very easily. All right. I think I've seen enough around here. Let's get back into space. Yeah, I actually also did, I think, one, maybe two streams on YouTube as well. But yeah, I mean, streaming is fine from time to time, but I'm more into video editing and doing talking points and that stuff. So normally I rather want to play on my own without streaming. Depends on my mood. Okay, so I should promptly get back into armor here. I mean, it's all just a hobby. I don't have any ambitions becoming a real YouTuber or a real streamer or anything like that. I'm happy when people are just watching my videos and give a like here and there, or maybe a comment, something like that. And if not, it's also fine. It's more the act of making those videos than necessarily showing them off. Okay. All right, claim this. And oh, I think I'm taking the Aurora. I haven't taken that for forever. Yeah. Sometimes I really feel bad when I neglect some ships. I don't know why it's so stupid, but Yeah, there's lots of stuff to learn. Always more. Still a bit annoyed. I'm really a big fan of HDR, high dynamic range, more color depth stuff. And I think this looks really amazing on a good computer screen, but I have some software to record it, but I have no software to edit those videos then. So there are some programs that can do it, but those are so expensive. And I really hope that this will become more mainstream, because I want to do all my video material with HDR support. Though I'm still not sure how common it is, but I think every modern computer screen supports it. Okay, I like the voice of the Russian ship more. It's not this trick. Okay, where are we going? I don't want to go to Clio. I've been there just. Calliope. I think it's Calliope today. Let's go over there. There we go. Well, not quite. I wish you could disable chat in general. I think for all the RSI ships, Chris Roberts should do the voices. That would be way more fun. Okay, where are we going? Oh, there's quite a lot of stuff on that moon, actually. So maybe here? Yeah, I know. You can turn it off, but it will eventually turn on again. I wanted to disable it completely, but yeah, maybe at some point. That's really bright. Yeah, let's get down there and see. Maybe change up some settings here. Nope. Da-da-da. Get this up a bit. Ugh, come on. Come on. Why can't I? Let's. Oh, okay. Heh? Okay, I'm confused now. This is turned off, right? Yeah. Nice music. Just recognize because normally I'm playing with music turned off, but very gentle, soothing. These rocks look crazy. Let me have a closer look here. I can't even make out the shape. Very alien. Oh. The frame rate is rather bad now. Stuttering. Ugh. Okay. Why is that green? That green stuff here, is that some minerals or something? I don't think anything lives here, right? I think it's too cold, but. Oh, okay. Okay, I really have to say, I think I have not checked out this moon enough. It's a lot of new looking stuff. Is that grass? Or algae? Let me get out there. I want to take a closer look. Exit, exit. Oh, exit. Exit, yeah. Hello? Ah. 70 minutes. Okay, I think we can do that. What is this? What are we looking at here? Rope. I have no idea. And I want to see what's over there. Run! This thing. Okay, that's really cool. There's like a pool of ice Too bad it's clipping very badly here. I want to see more of that, but can we? Is there another maybe somewhere around here? Ah, over there. That's also clipping. I mean, no wonder with all those mountains. But this could look kind of cool. I mean, that's not how it's supposed to work, right? Or is it? I'm not even sure. It's huge. This moon is just random. Okay, let me see. Nope. Doesn't help either. Can I get the details? I don't think so. I mean, it's interesting, but it's not beautiful. It's just randomly littered stuff. Okay, let's get back to the ship. Maybe we find place somewhere around here that's a bit less random and still has those interesting assets. I'm gonna break my legs here. Okay. How convenient that you can enter the ship from both sides. Okay. Still really cool to find stuff in the game that I haven't not seen before. I did turn off the engine, I guess. Engine on. Okay. Maybe if we can find it. What's that down there? Okay, that are some funky looking rocks. What an enormous boulder. Okay, I wanna maybe put down the ship there for scale. Landing gear still down. I mean, it's not that. Nope. It doesn't even look that big this way. Probably would have to get out in person. That's better, but yeah, it's kind of cool, but then again, this landscape's so wild. Okay, let me see, maybe. Up or down? I think down. Okay, and don't crash. Don't crash. Oh, that's quite windy. So alien looking. I love it. Okay, sorry if this camera angle is not the best for flying here, but I just want to look around a bit. I mean, the ground texture is really not that impressive, but wow, the rest is, I would say. Okay, this one. Nope. Way around. So much stuff going on down there. Really don't even know what I should focus at, but maybe try this. Oops. Wow. I mean, what is this? Crazy. Okay. Now let's go somewhere else. And I don't find anything else interesting. I probably call it a day. We see, okay, some nice looking mountains over there. Okay, these almost look like glaciers. I haven't found any of those puddles anymore, I think. There's one. Shoot. That better integrated? I don't know. Those look really weird. And the terrain is again clipping through it. I need to find those on a more plain surface. But all I see are more mountains. Mountains of madness, I tell you. Wow. I don't know. People are complaining that There are no high mountains in the game. Those kind of feel high to me, but yeah, I mean, probably if you're going to really measure it, it's not even that much, but it's enough to trigger my vertigo. Okay, let me get down there. Ooh. Some nice flying here. I would say. I have no idea. Okay, I feel like this moon only has mountains. There are no plains at all. There's one, but don't see any of those puddles. Ah, there's one to the left, but I'm afraid that's again. Yeah. I mean, I'm not even sure they're interesting, but they are quite low res, not very good looking. Okay. I think I call it a day with this. So, thanks for stopping by. I hope you liked the stream. If you did so, consider following my channel and yeah, consider looking at my YouTube channel as well. And with that, see ya.